Hey folks, in this video, I'm going to help you work faster in Unreal 5. It's also going to take off some of the pain and strain on your wrists, and you'll look a little like a pro while you're working. In addition, it's going to help you adapt to some of the changes in Unreal 5, things like navigating really large environments, finding that right asset out of thousands, and also structuring your content so that you'll be able to work more effectively with teams. So how I'm going to do this is break it down into three combined activities with shortcuts: navigation and layout, creation and organization, and playtesting and diagnostics. So without further ado, let's jump in and get started. All right, so here we are. We've got the 100 gigabyte Valley of the Ancients demo loaded up in Unreal, and it looks gorgeous. So the first thing that I wanted to go over was navigation. So selecting an object and hitting the F key to frame up on it is a really effective way to get around large environments. But as you can see, now I'm moving the camera up and it's taking a long time if I wanted to go higher. So the next thing I wanted to show was the camera speed. So for an environment like this, you could go all the way up to 7. You have to adjust the camera to feel what seems to be the right camera speed. So here we are, we've hooked around again. We look back and we say, oh my God, I'm lost in the middle of the desert and I forgot my water back at camp. So how do we get back? Well, that's where bookmarks come in, and thankfully I've set some. So I'm gonna hit the 1 key and here we are, back at camp. I'm gonna set the camera speed to an appropriate speed for camp here, which is 3. Now it seems like I'm moving right. But how do we set those bookmarks? Well, if you hit the control key plus 1, 2, 3, 4, it'll set a bookmark for any of those locations. And it's just really useful. You got to get used to using those, especially for large environments, or if you're doing something like virtual production and you're doing virtual scouting, because you're going to be dropping spots where you might want to shoot from. Okay, so next, let's talk about layout. Let's go back to this object here. W, E, and R translate, rotate, and scale. The other thing that I want to point out is moving assets around the environment and keeping the camera. So right now, if you just drag the asset, you'll eventually get out of range. But if you hold down the shift key, it'll move your camera along with the asset itself. Okay, wonderful. So we've gotten through navigation and layout. Let's move on. For creation and organization, the content browser is the way to go. So control and space bar will pull up the content browser on demand and you can make it go away so you have more workspace. In addition, the content browser has a lot of nice improvements. You can get quick access to Quixel, which has got 15,000 and growing number of assets and materials. So if you haven't checked out Quixel Bridge, check it out. It's wonderful. And also, you can not only have one content browser, you can have multiple content browsers. So I have set up this content browser with a filter. So folders, findings, and filters are the way to go with Unreal for getting access to the content that you need on a timely basis. So filter, I went to FX, and Niagara emitters, and then when I clicked on this, it just shows me the elements that I need. And what's great is I can just pull up the other content browser on top of it. If I wanted to put a bunch of assets that I got, say from Quixel or from even like duplicate assets into my own folder, I could just click here, Control Shift N creates a new folder. And then sometimes it's hard to know which ones are yours. So I often like to color my folders. I already set a color. You could say new color. But yeah, that sets it to a color, which is wonderful. What if you want to rename it? I hit F2. That's a fast way of naming your content. Usually what I like to do is I like to put in folders that help organize similar types of content. But if I'm working on things that are like a material and a static mesh and a blueprint at the same time, that's where I might use a collection. So if you create a collection, low collection, my collection, and I spelled that wrong, but that's where F2 comes in, which is really great. And then you can just go in and just drag anything into that collection. So it shows up and you just drag those in and they would all show up in that collection. And the collection is just a pointer. They all still exist in their local folders. So that's really great. How about the reverse? What do I mean by that? What if I want to work on this character, but I don't know where she is because there's so many assets? That's where Control B will get you what you want. It just pulls it up in the asset in the content browser, which is wonderful. Also, sometimes you're going to want to work on like the material itself. So what if I want to find a material that's connected to one of the assets? So I've selected the asset. If you just click the browse button, it will take you to the material itself. Okay. The last thing in creation and organization would be the level blueprint. I'm always opening up the level blueprint, and right now I set this to Alt Dash on my keyboard, and this is a custom hotkey I set. I'll show how to set this up at the end here. But also Control and Tab allows you to tab between different elements. Really, really useful. It's going to save you so much time and so much wear and tear on your wrists. Okay, great. Let's wrap things up by going into Playtesting and Diagnostics. So if you select an object and you want to open up its specific editor, you can use the Control E key. So what do I mean by that? Well, this is a static mesh and it opened up the static mesh editor. But if I selected a blueprint and hit Control E, it opened up the blueprint editor. Awesome. It's so useful. Use that all the time. So if you've just adjusted the collisions on an object and you want to see that visualized in the scene, then quite often I will hit Alt C to see the collisions in the scene. That's great, but sometimes you need to be able to see these with different views turned on. So you might want to switch to an unlit mode, which is Alt 3, or the wireframe mode. Not as useful sometimes, but sometimes it is exactly what you need. So flipping between the different view modes or without textures on, it's Alt 5. I'll put a list together and put it the notes below of all the different console commands and also the view modes. So speaking of console commands, let's flip back to Alt 4 and I'm going to turn off collisions. If you hit the tilde key and then you say dump console commands, right there, and then click that, you will be able to then, if you go pull up output log, you'll get a full list of all the console commands that are possible. It's a long list, but you can copy and paste those into a browser and take a look at them. So that might be useful. The measure tool. Sometimes for your layout, you might want to measure different parts of your scene. And so you need an orthographic view in order to use the measure tool. So if you hold down Alt H to pull up a front view or Alt J to put a top view, and then you use the middle mouse button and drag. You can use a measure tool. That's useful at times. So I'm going to go back. So Alt G, snapping back. Thankfully, the frame rate command, I use that. Control Shift H pulls up frame rates. And then finally, to test the level, you're going to hit Alt P. Okay, so we've launched the level, and if I want to get out of the level, obviously it's the escape key, but sometimes you don't want to start the level at this spot. Sometimes you want to playtest from a certain location somewhere else, so you can also right-click and say play from here, and that's useful. Sometimes you're not going to be able to if you have blueprints set up, so you sometimes can turn the blueprints off or drag your player start to that area that you want to test. Those are the playtesting and diagnostics. Let's go over how to make our own custom shortcuts. To do that, you go to Edit and Editor Preferences, and then you go to Keyboard Shortcuts. And there are hundreds and hundreds, maybe thousands of possible shortcut keys. The three that I think are important to add would be place actors. And I set that to Shift P. We'll go over these in a second. Open level blueprints and to Alt hyphen. And finally, world settings to Alt W. So I'm going to tab back here and we'll do them each now. So Shift P will open up the place actors. And so this should look a little familiar if you used Unreal 4, which is really nice. In addition, The shift key plus 1 through 8 will open up all of these different creation menus. So saving this for last. And then finally, we already showed the alt hyphen for opening up the level blueprints, which is really useful. Every once in a while, you might need the world setting. So I have that set to like alt W when you want to set your game mode or something like that. So that's useful. If you by accident close your details palette, that's still the default from Unreal 4, which is just hitting F4 to pull that back. Wonderful. I'm going to give 2 quick tips for those who stuck it out. As you use Unreal for more specific tasks like sequencer only work or character animation only work, you will probably get your layout just the way you want it for those specific tasks. And when you do, what I recommend is going to Window, Save Layouts. That will let you save your palettes. Then you can just reload those specific layouts. And I think we'll probably see some specific layouts that people will create in the near future for specific tasks as well. Another is, quite often, I might want to see this whole details palette along this bar right here. And there's a new move to sidebar that's in Unreal 5. And that allows you to get this entire details palette. And then when I want the world outliner back, I just click there and then I can get the whole world outliner. So it's a really nice feature. And those are the 2 tips. That's a lot of information. So you might want to review this because sometimes to go slow first allows you to go fast. And going slow and memorizing a bunch of hotkeys is not always fun, but you just go so much faster at the end and you save your wrists. So wonderful. Hopefully that was useful for you. There are no hotkeys for awesomeness or for attractiveness. I checked. That'll wrap things up. If you like the video, hit like. You can also subscribe. There are no hotkeys for liking or subscribing, but you can hit shift and question mark to see what hotkeys are available in YouTube. But that'll wrap things up. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next one.